I can see very well that the bottom of the reef is broken back. I can see it very well. There's a joke and I know it very well. It's one of that I told you long ago.
That's right. Oh yes, here we go. What's going on, everybody? Death in the air here. And today, finally, I told you there's gonna be a lot of Elton John content coming. Well, fucking strap yourselves onto that rocket and get ready for nine songs of 24 fucking kick-ass Elton John's 1971 fucking masterpiece, Madman, Across the Fucking Water. I absolutely adore, worship, and love this record. It is, so far on my journey with Elton, this is probably my favorite. This album is so fucking great. So fucking great. The title track alone just grabbed me right away. Because when I was first starting my journey with Elton's music, this was Jerry Cantrell from Alice in Chains said that this is his favorite album from Elton. And there's an interview he did or somewhere he's talking about it, and he held it, and I was like, well, I love Jerry Cantrell, I love Alice in Chains, so what the fuck. And right before I went and saw Rocket Man, I did my homework and I listened to his Superior 70 shit, and this one, Captain Fantastic, and Goodbye Yellow Brick Road just grabbed me right away. And fuck, man. So where do we begin? This came out a year after Tumbleweed Connection, and 2 years after self-titled, and 2 or 3 years after Empty Sky. So by this point, he was just flushing them out. This album is mostly well only known for Tiny Dancer, which is one of his greatest and most well-known songs, but my god, there's so much other great shit on here. I'm gonna talk about all that. This was recorded in, with some notes here, Give me a second. Down. This is his fourth studio album, released in 1971. He recorded it from February 9th, 10th, or the 9th and 11th and the 14th, through August of 1971. I think right off the bat, one of the things that I really loved about it is it's like progressive rock mixed in with all these different deep and emotional lyrics from Bernie Taupin, and it so much flavor to it, so much variety, so much strength. I love the sound of it. This is also the second album to feature Davey Johnstone and Dee Murray and Nigel Olsen, who really wouldn't become... Oh wait, no, he had Nigel on this, because there's a whole fucking awesome fucking thing he did for the BBC. I think it was called Sounds for Saturday, where he played pretty much the whole album from Tiny Dancer to Goodbye, and I've watched that a lot, and it's fucking great. So, like I said, Tiny Dancer is the most well-known song from this record, but you got like Lee Vaughn, which I think is also probably the most well-known. The title track, Razor Faced, All the Nasties, Goodbye, which is so emotionally, it's heartbreaking. The title track itself, like I said, fuck man, the first time I saw that, I watched it, it was like an 11-minute performance he did of it. He just improvises in between all of it. It's fucking awesome. I love the lyrics. Especially the pre-chorus. I love how it builds. And then when he hits the chorus, another glimpse of the madman across the water. And he holds that really, really long note. It's like building to this explosion. And live he puts like an extra oomph on that. Another glimpse. And like really fucking puts so much emotion into it. The string parts too from that concert he did in 1986 with the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra. Oh man, so fucking sharp. There is one song on here though that I think could be in the top three or four greatest songs he's ever written in his whole career. One that doesn't get talked about enough or brought up enough or doesn't get the recognition deserves. Holiday Inn too. I love that song. But that's not it. I kind of want to go into it now. I kind of want to save it, but what the fuck. Indian Sunset. My God. The way it starts off. And that's very melancholy. Starts off painting this picture of this broken Native American soldier, and the first like half keyboard and goes into this fucking crazy ass piano thing he does. It's so fucking beautiful. And it's, and the madness and what he's describing and telling you. That song is one of the reasons that just made me love Elton, because he's able to take Bernie's lyrics and put these amazing melodies to them, but the pace in which he sings this and how he's describing what's going on in Bernie's lyrics is just fucking mind-blowing. Elton is like the perfect fucking artist for me because I love that shit so much. And I also think that Indian Sunset is just, it's incredibly accurate. And like I said, I think it's one of the greatest songs he's ever written. That's like up there with All of Goodbye, Yellow Brick Road, Funeral for a Friend, and Benny and the Jets, Candle in the Wind. It's on that level to me. Unless you're like hardcore, but I don't really see that much praise for this song, but it more than deserves it. It is fucking just heart riveting, and just every little fucking second of it takes you on this insane ride. And truly, truly underrated. Plus, this was just a year after, and on just a matter of a year and two months after he played at the Troubadour in August of 70. So just a year, August to November of 71, a year he's writing shit like this. And Tiny Dancer being about his and Bernie's experience of that, about how beautiful California girls and all that, and just fucking amazing material, man. Plus, like I said, every song is so different from each other, and it's not like there's nothing that's repetitive. There's nothing that no fucking there's no not one song you skip on here either. I think that All the Nasties and Goodbye are probably the two most heart-wrenching songs in there. Like, sorry seems to be the hardest word that on that kind of level. All the Nasties being about him at the time, him being in the closet, and oh, what would my fans that I was starting to get say, or the press say, that how he repeats the line, oh, my soul, at the end. And Goodbye is just, my God, it makes you fucking cry. It's so heartbreaking, like, sorry seems to be the hardest word. It's only like a minute and 49 seconds long. He really hit a fucking nerve on this album for me. And it's now maybe considered one of his most classics, but at the time it came out, no one really appreciated, I guess, the genius of it, from like what I've read and what I've watched on stuff on his, like, kind of look back on his career or whatever. Holy shit, man. Holy shit. Fucking Holy shit. And also in Rocket Man, there's a, you kind of get that vibe in Tiny Dancer. When we're at a party at Mama Cass's, but. But just to. I mean, not alone, man. He had Empty Sky, which was really. I mean, it was his debut album. I haven't really, like. Skyline Pigeon is a great song. And then he had Tumblebee Connection. Oh no, then you had the Elton John album, which is your song, 60 Years On, Rockin' with Madonna. So much great shit on there. Take Me to the Pilot. That album is fucking amazing. Then Tumblebee Connection, which is next on my pickups and his vinyl. I was gonna get the other day, but yeah. So, by the time we got to this, it's like, his genius was just fucking going, man. And this is right before all the drugs and shit, too. But man, just to be able to accomplish all that in a year, making your debut in America, that's fucking amazing. And I think that's kind of what I love about this too, the charm of this record is it's not over layered either. All the parts seem to fit really well together. He really struck a fucking nerve with this, man. And things were just really starting to take off for him too. And but it kind of sucks that when it came out, no one really fucking was able to appreciate the genius of it. I think it took a movie called Almost Famous, where the band in the movie plays or sings a song together, and then out of nowhere, it became a huge hit for him, but. Leave On Too. Beautiful fucking song. I love all the piano shit in it. I don't know why I play. Probably has nothing to do with it, but a song really reminds me of Sanford and Son for some reason. I love that show so much, but I don't know why it just does. It has nothing to do with it or anything, but at this time in America, though, that show was just starting to get huge. Rest in peace, Red Fox. One of the greatest comedians of all time. Anyway, then you have, Hit Holiday Inn. I love the chorus to that about Holiday Inns and starting his life on the road, being a touring musician. I wonder what made Bernie write all the nasties, because I mean, maybe that could have been something later on in his career, like after 75 maybe. But, at that time, being gay was just so taboo or whatever, and, but, I mean, who really gives a fuck? It made a difference if he was gay or if he wasn't. I mean, who gives a fuck if he's gay? His music is what matters. I mean, he definitely, like, in this period, wasn't, out fucking rageous with all those outfits he wore, but, I mean, if you couldn't tell by, like, 73 or 74, then, but anyway, really, who gives a shit about that? I mean, maybe gay, but holy fuck, man. He wrote this bad motherfucker. And it's just, I would have, there's a little bit in his book where he talks about it, but I would have, I'd love to hear him talk about this album more and how he kind of came up with a material for the rest of the songs, because he has talked about Tiny Dancer a lot, so is Bernie, but I don't know, maybe I haven't looked hard enough, but from what I've researched on it, I haven't really found where he talks about any of the other songs. Because Indian Sunset deserves all the fucking praise it deserves to everything. It's fucking amazing. And like I said, how it starts in one place, like it's very frantic, and then he kind of brings the tone down. And then at the end, builds into another amazing crescendo. That's Apex songwriting right there. You can't fuck with that at all. So, yeah, man, 10 out of 10. I love every song on this. This is Captain Fantastical. And this are my favorite two so far, but like I said, I barely scratched the surface. Because I've been playing Captain Fantastic a lot as well. That album is fucking monster. So, and Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, that's like right there too. So, but this one, man, if you're one of those who just know Tiny Dancer, investigate the rest of this. Title track alone hooked me, and there's another great live version of it, and it's from his 60th birthday show he did in 2007 in New York, Madison Square Garden. Very, 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 very fucking amazing performance as well, and he played it like second in the set too. 60 years on, and that, my God. Plus in that show, he busted out Holiday Inn, Leave On, of course Tiny Dancer. He did quite a good chunk of material from Madman in that show as well. What can I say, man? I fucking love this album. It's my favorite from him. I figured I'd start off with my favorite and what really hooked me beginning this journey with Elton's music. And there's another great performance of Tiny Dancer, just him by himself at what was it called? Fuck. Old Grey Whistle Test. I think that's where it was from. Used to be this pretty popular thing in the UK. Skinner did one, Judas Priest did one. Skinner just fucking great. I've watched that quite a lot. And this also to me just is like, he's like on the verge, just on the verge of like Funeral for a Friend and Love Lies Bleeding and all that. Rocket Man, Honky Cat, Hercules, Candle in the Wind, Beating the Jets. It's like, he's just like right there. Daniel, Crocodile Rock, Have Mercy on the Criminal. It's like, just to know that this was right before he'd make all that other great material. Man, it must have been fucking exciting, man. Like, really fucking exciting. Because this alone, I mean, it's like, it's kind of like he, like, how can I top myself? How can I top myself? It's Honky Chateau and Don't Shoot Me, I'm Only the Piano Player, to follow this, and those albums are fucking great as well. But I feel that even with his 70s material, which is probably the apex, and it's superior, it's the apex and it's so superior to anything in his career, is even the most popular songs from that period, during that time, I feel there's also more that kind of get overlooked. And on every album review that I do, I'm going to point all those out, because I think that Elton kind of falls in the same category as Metallica, whereas, like, Master of Puppets is Master of Puppets, but there's so many other great songs on that album. Like, I think Funeral for a Friend and Love Lies Bleeding is Elton's Master of Puppets. But yet, and that song's very well known. I mean, it starts off Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, but the whole Love Lies Bleeding part is great. But the fucking, like, I don't know, like a 5 minute fucking ride through the instrumental part that kicks it all off. Especially, I mean, and then the drama of it, it's like something that could have been written by a fucking classical orchestra or some shit. So anyway, I highly recommend this motherfucker, man. 1971, it's Madman Across the Water. The album's fucking really fucking starting to shine. And I highly recommend it. Like, it's his fourth album too, so a span of, what, just 5 years of doing it already? That's fucking amazing. So yeah, I guess that's all I got. Check this motherfucker out. And if you love Elton John as much as I am, and give this, if you have this album, check out all the other songs in there, because Indian Sunset, the title track, oh, great shit. Leave On, but some people know that one really well, they don't. But this album is fucking amazing, man. And listen to it and never get tired of it. So, it's gonna be coming up. I think next I'm gonna do either Honky Chateau or Goodbye Yellow Brick Road. And with Metallica, I gotta get Load and Reload done. But I've been thinking about, like, off the cuff figures I can deal with them too, because I really want to do a video on the tour of the Black Album. So anyways, give this fucking beast a spin on your fucking player if you have it. Not go out and buy it right fucking now, but worth it. Get it on Amazon for pretty cheap. So until next time, death in the air. Stay fucking heavy.